Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, today we're going to review the Game Changers.
Selling that idea that real men eat meat. But you got to understand, that's marketing. That's not based on reality.
So, finally, I watched The Game Changers. Guys, a little bit of a background story here. When I first heard about The Game Changers, I was still a vegan. And that must have been around about 3 years ago or so. Needless to say, I was very excited, right? I was a vegan bodybuilder myself. At that moment in time, I was pursuing to be a vegan, a plant-based bodybuilder. Needless to say, that pursuit failed. Now, a couple of years later, I am on an animal-based diet, predominantly animal foods, very high in meat, and I am thriving. Since The Game Changers got announced, a lot of things happened. Many athletes that were starring in that movie dropped out. One example, Tim Sheaf. Other athletes got injured. They ended their careers. They are not plant-based any longer. Even Novak Djokovic, one of the producers, is not vegan any longer. Nowadays, he's on a plant-based diet, incorporated fish or eggs. So the reason that I'm mentioning that this movie has been in the making for many, many years is that it didn't age well. It didn't age well at all. It is very repetitive. Guys, if you've watched the trailer, you've seen it all. There is absolutely no reason for you to watch this movie. It was a humongous disappointment. And of course, I get it. I have a bias here right now as a so-called carnivore. I'm watching a vegan propaganda movie. And of course, I'm not gonna love it. However, I try to be as objective as possible, and many times I try to remind myself and think about how I would perceive this movie if I still would be vegan. But no matter how I would look at the movie, it was still an absolute catastrophe. That movie was severely underwhelming. You wouldn't get attached to the protagonists. There is no real background story. It starts with a retired MMA fighter who wants to cure his injuries faster, who wants to heal up faster. Then he finds out about a plant-based diet and believes that this will enhance his healing. Then they throw a couple of runners in there, a couple of vegan bodybuilders. Nima Delgado has maybe 3 or 5 seconds airtime. Really, really short segment. As I said, nothing that you wouldn't have seen in the trailer. And the big peak of the movie is Patrick Baboumian doing a little yoke lift on a stage at a veg fest, I believe. So no real strongman competition or anything on those lines. Just Patrick Baboumian performing an act in front of a couple of vegans. And that is the great finale of this movie. On top of that, there is this absolutely pathetic pursuit to infuse some sort of environmental and health information into this documentary. Because of time reasons, they of course cannot highlight the health aspect, quote-unquote health aspect, and they cannot talk too much about the environment. However, they still chose to infuse it into this so-called sport documentary. It doesn't make any sense. It looks very, very unorganized. It just doesn't fit well. There is no clear direction where this movie is headed. As I said, it didn't age well at all. All of those so-called vegan facts have been debunked since. The environmental aspect, the health aspect, the ethical aspect. In those couple of years where they were sitting there trying to rewrite the movie again because so many athletes dropped out, the whole nutritional world has changed again. Therefore, I felt as if I was watching a documentary from 2015. So aside from the vegan propaganda, just looking at this movie from a filmographic standpoint, I have to say I couldn't see the fingerprints of James Cameron at all. I really doubt that James Cameron really overlooked this project. I believe he just put his face on it and gave it his go. It is an absolute mediocre production. This is something that you could see on a YouTube documentary. If you want to put it on Netflix, then well, so be it. But by no means is this something that you would pay for in the cinema. Absolutely pathetic attempt to promote this message. It's quite interesting to see how this life works. The universe gives you the things that you do not need anymore, right? When I was a vegan, I was waiting for this documentary. Yes, it will change the world. The Game Changers. Really, really strong title there. But now that I'm not vegan anymore, I couldn't care less. However, I was worried a little bit. And I said, maybe they will push the propaganda strong with this. Arnold Schwarzenegger is behind it. Jackie Chan is behind it. This could be a threat. But let me tell you guys, absolute false alarm. This thing is no threat by any means. It flopped at the box office. It will fail online as well. This is by no means a game changer. The only real game changer is the plant-based diet that has been adapted by those athletes. Those guys suffer, and in the end, they will have to really change their game, change their careers, and choose another profession altogether. I was excited for this. I thought it's going to be exciting to watch, exciting to critique. This will be an interesting review. However, this movie does not allow it. It is an absolute catastrophe, an absolute failure. Anyways, guys, I want to announce it here on my channel. I've been in cooperation with a couple of filmmakers and other people, such as Sean Baker and Chris Kruger. And what we have planned, just a little spoiler here, is a mini documentary in which we will rebuttal every single athlete in the Game Changers movie. So therefore, again, this is just a quick review. The real anti-Game Changers documentary is yet to come. It's going to be an amazing project where we will work all together and create a film against them. So anyway, stay tuned for that. If you want to support the channel, all the links are in the description box. If you like the video, leave it a thumbs up. And as always, guys, much love and peace. We'll be right back.